Hello and welcome to all of you for today's lecture. Now today we'll see the MCQs based on the chapters like Carbanion and Wittig reaction, etc. Now first of all, the correct order of stability of carbanion is, now there are four carbanions given. Now carbanion stability, we know that the stabilization of carbanion can be achieved through inductive resonance and so on. Like here, lack of resonance will make this carbanion less stable. Here resonance is there, but now amongst these three, where the resonance would be higher, of course it will be higher when the charge comes here. So I am just drawing the canonical structure of this carbanion. It will be N double bond O minus. Now minus you can put it here as well as you can put it here. So NO2 group will facilitate the stability by the virtue of resonance effect. So in this case resonance is not possible because CH3 will in fact destabilize the carbanion. If negative charge comes here and methyl group is there, that is electron donor, will destabilize the carbanion. So 3 should be first, then second, then this one, and then so the first order is correct. Third is more stable than second. This one. Second is more stable, in fact. Third is more stable than second. Then comes fourth, and then comes here. Yeah, this one. Which of the following carbanion is more stable? So, normally primary carbanions are more stable. Identify the compound with active methylene group. Now there are so many methylene groups, 1, 2, 3, 4, all compounds have methylene group in them, but the most stable is this one, or this methylene group is containing active hydrogen atom. You can abstract this proton with a base like NaOET, NaOMe, so that this carbanion will be enjoying the resonance by the virtue of CN as well as COET group. So this is the active methylene group amongst the given set. Then fourth example, cyclohexanone to this aldehyde, the missing reagent, whether it is this phosphorus slide, this one, or this one. So I'll just show the simple mechanism to make it understand. So this is the carbonyl group, and now we have PPH3CH minus, and then OME is there. Okay, this is the phosphorus slide we are talking about. Now this will give you a betaine intermediate, that is the characteristic of your phosphorus slide, this betaine, then loses triphenyl phosphinoxide and it becomes this one. On hydrolysis will give you a geminal diol which loses water, and eventually this becomes the aldehyde. So this is one of the modified reagent for the homologation from the cyclohexanone you can get this aldehyde. So the third option is correct. Now moving on to the fifth example, or fifth question rather. It's aldehyde to the ethyl cinnamate, benzaldehyde to ethyl cinnamate, how to get that. Now here also you have to start with the aldehyde, and then I'll just show the compound with CH COAT PPH3. I'm just putting the normal form. Eventually you have O PPH3, that will be there, and then this is the carbon which is bearing COAT. Once again this comes here, this goes off, and since the phosphorus slide is stabilized one, you get only E alkene. So with a stabilized slide, the chances of getting E alkenes are maximum, so this will be the major product. With unstabilized lead, you may end up with the Z alkene. Okay. The next example is this acid can be prepared from malonate ester involving steps. Now, four options are given. I'll just put malonate ester first of all, COAT, the methylene protons are there, OMe can abstract this, you get the carbanion. Now this carbanion is stabilized because it can enjoy the stabilization by the virtue of resonance effect. Then PHCH2Br, the alkylation, so you can introduce PHCH2 group here straight away, COOET. If you hydrolyze it, this becomes PHCH2, COOH. Now this is, since it is beta keto acid, it undergo decarboxylation upon heating and you get the target molecule, that is PHCH2CH2COOH. So from malonate ester, these are the steps. So first option is correct. First option is correct, that is benzyl bromide followed by hydrolysis and decarboxylation upon heating. A similar question is there from ethyl acetoacetate, ethyl methyl ketone. Ethyl methyl ketone is this compound, and we want to synthesize it from ethyl acetoacetate, that is CH3CO CH2COOH. So when you start with this compound, first of all you have to put methyl group here, then methylation NaOAT. We cannot use NaOH because NaOH will hydrolyze this. So NaOAT can abstract this proton, active methylene, and you can get the methylation. Then next step is the hydrolysis of ester into acid. Now this is beta keto acid, So this has a property of losing the CO2 and you get ethyl methyl ketone. So the first option, that is NaOMe methyl iodide hydrolysis, and so those are the steps involved in the formation of this ethyl methyl ketone, starting with the ethyl acetoacetate, in which substrate carbanion can be easily generated. Now here I'll directly put the answer over here and then we'll explain. Like this can enjoy the stabilization by the virtue of benzene ring, as well as you can stabilize it in with the nitrile group also. In rest of the compounds, that is absent. So this is the correct way to generate the carbanion, and this benzylic protons are highly acidic and you can generate it easily. Then the next one is the most acidic protons. Acidic protons are present in, now there are four options: E, methane, B, nitromethane, C, ethane, and D, the dimethyl ether. Of course, in this case, you can generate the carbanion using, say, base like potassium carbonate in aqueous methanol. So you can get this. Now this is the stable most. Now here you can generate, but that pK value will be very low for like pK value will be very high for the other compounds. So here this is acidic enough to be abstracted by K2CO3. So that is the thing. One more example I'll put. Substearidyl aldehyde is there and we want to transform that compound into this olefin. The reagent is asked. There are four options. I will put those options here. So this is out of context, like competition, because this will give E olefin. Now here we want Z olefin. This is Z olefin. Now Z olefin is possible only by the less stable phosphorus slide. So this is the correct option because we want to have this isopropyl group there. So this is that CH which is appearing here. Or let me put, yeah, this one is CH and then two methyls are there. Let us write down the mechanism. I'll just put R here, then triphenyl phosphine and then CH and then, okay, minus plus. So you got to have the isopropyl group here. So this will bond, that is the accessory. So this is the correct option. So when you add this, of course it will go through butane, so it will be OPPH3 CH, isopropyl group CH, and then R, whatever is there, then so you get this compound. So this carbon is coming from aldehyde, this is this carbon, and the accessory is there, that is there. Now my suggestion to you is you go through the syllabus, read the basics, because most of the MCQs will be based upon the basic chemistry, and therefore knowing basic chemistry will help you immensely. Memorizing the thing will not help you in case of organic chemistry, because organic chemistry needs understanding of the concepts. So if you do it nicely, you can score very good marks, because this is like mathematics, you can score full marks also in this subject. Next time I'll come up with some other MCQs, because one option, like one chapter is still there, that is rearrangement is there, I think. So I'll make one more video, and then with that we'll be concluding the teaching part of this semester. So we'll meet soon. Thank you.